The name of the game in flight test is in-flight validation. When we go out and fly the airplane you see behind me, this is the final proof that yes, this is a real airplane in real air with real engines, real pilots, and flight test is the only way to do that in terms of validating those labs and validating the design. My name's Scott Martin, experimental test pilot at Gulfstream. We know there's going to be a wonderful new customer experience when they get in the flight deck for the first time and say, wow, this is what I've always wanted but really couldn't describe until I saw it. We have 10 touchscreens on the airplane because of the flexibility they offer. I can take a single device and I can make it whatever I want it to be. It can be a display of information, it can be a control input, it can be both. Among those is a phase of flight menu, which is a tailored menu for a specific phase of a specific flight that gives you the pilot just the exact items he needs. I do everything right here in front of me. Transition time from a column and wheel to a side stick is a matter of seconds. Typically, we put pilots who've never flown any kind of side stick before in one of our laboratories, and usually a few seconds after the first takeoff, they forget they're even flying a side stick. It's that quick, that easy, that simple. Data concentration network is when you first turn on, it powers up, it becomes aware, ooh, I'm on the ground, I'm not moving, the engines are off. I bet the pilot's gonna wanna start the engines here pretty soon, so I'm gonna put all those switches and I'm gonna set them all up for startup. In addition, you get quite a bit of monitoring of systems on board the airplane, and in some cases, the DCN can even fix a problem for the pilot, and the airplane is almost becoming self-aware. It's absolutely a resounding success. I attribute it to the upfront investment we did to the laboratories and the freedom to go design that flight deck that every pilot wants.